It was April 9th, 2009, Good Friday, when wildfires raged through several communities just west of Fort Worth in north central Texas. Choking black smoke billowed across the horizon as hundreds of firefighters worked frantically to extinguish the fires, but it was fruitless. The fires were everywhere and they were devastating. That afternoon, 208 wildfires charred 140,000 acres of land. 4 people were killed. 2 entire towns were burned through, and 114 homes were destroyed. How could something like this happen, and why? In just the last 5 years, these deadly Southern Plains wildfire outbreaks, or firestorms, have been reported 10 times. Those 10 firestorms resulted in 287 fires that burned 2.5 million acres, destroyed 1,065 structures, and killed 22 people. The statistics are staggering, but they're made even worse by the fact that we believe these firestorms will happen again.
In 2006, the National Weather Service identified what they called the Southern Plains outbreak pattern. Since then, we've documented 10 events over the past 5 years. Fires that occur on those days are very destructive and very large. We've seen them occur on the High Plains near Amarillo. We've seen them occur in the Southern Plains near San Angelo. And in 2009, we saw outbreak fires occur in North Texas near Fort Worth. The common denominator with these fires are the cured grasses that occur during the winter seasons in late spring across Texas. The cured grasses act as a catalyst and allow these fires to spread fast and to spread large distances. The fire growth is very significant. Some of these fires have moved over 50 miles in one day. The speed at which these fires travel is very hard to comprehend. When we say 3 to 6 miles per hour, what is that? A person walking at a brisk pace generally walks about 4 miles per hour. 6 miles per hour, if you take that down to distance per minute, you're looking at 2 football fields covered in 1 minute's time. So it's moving faster than what you think, and as firefighters, it's very difficult to keep up with a fire moving this fast. It quickly outpaces our efforts to keep up with it and contain it. And there's not much out there that can stop them. We've seen them cross interstate highways, 4 lanes and a median. That won't stop them during the peak burning period. The only thing that really stops these fires are something of the nature of plowed fields without any fuel on them, or in most cases, it's the weather itself changes. The wind quits blowing and the relative humidity goes up. That is really what stops the fires in most cases.
Greg Murdoch, a meteorologist with the National Weather Service, was among the researchers who discovered these weather patterns. He doesn't think we've seen the last of these potentially deadly firestorms.
One of the key principles in fire weather forecasting is keeping perspective on the scope of what's going on. And to do that, I have some fire weather forecast principles that I look at. I call these the IDA fire weather forecast principles. I is for intensity, D is for duration, and A is for the aerial coverage. A red flag warning or a fire weather watch is an indication that the influence of weather on a fire is great enough such that control problems or extreme fire behavior is expected. In comparison, a typical red flag day may have a wind of 20 to 25 miles an hour. However, on the South Plains outbreak type days, a sustained wind of 30 to 40 miles an hour with gusts of 60 or even higher are possible. Now, once this outbreak type pattern has been identified, these red flag warnings and fire weather watches will serve as the primary text vehicle to convey this information. Another way to think about this outbreak pattern is to compare it to a tornado watch, in that a tornado watch is not forecasting a tornado at a specific location, but saying that tornadoes are possible with thunderstorms that develop within this defined area. And the same idea holds with this South Plains outbreak pattern, that specific fires are not forecast at any particular location, at any particular county, but we're just saying that due to the extreme weather that large multiple occurrence fires are possible in that defined area. Now, the National Weather Service and the Texas Forest Service has made a concentrated effort to correlate fire occurrence and weather. And the takeaway here is that the National Weather Service can forecast the South Plains outbreak pattern, and it can be done days in advance. The National Weather Service has the utmost concern for firefighter and public safety, and in fact, it's at the heart of the products that we issue. Warnings on these outbreak days convey the most critical type of red flag information. These are not the run-of-the-mill type red flag warnings, but convey the worst of the worst weather conditions. And in fact, you can consider the weather to be in control. Be assured that on these South Plains outbreak days, the weather is very unforgiving.
The head of the fire, the front end of these fires, is burning very intensely. And in fact, we really have no effect, we being firefighters, on controlling or putting out the head of the fire. On April 9th of 2009, the fire moved through timber stands of post oak in North Texas. The fire was so intense that it actually burned in the tops of the trees, and the trees didn't have leaves on them. They were a dormant tree, but it burned through the branches. That's how intense the fire was. There was no way that anything, whether it be aircraft, engines, dozers, can do anything to stop that type of fire.
Community leaders and emergency responders in the North Central Texas area were thrown, quite literally, into a firestorm. They had a lot of decisions to make and little time to prepare.
Once all the tones started going out and all the fire started working, we had every piece of equipment in Young County, including all the oil field companies were loading up with water and hauling us water with their tank trucks. But there was not another piece of equipment left in a station in Young County. Everything was out working fires. We started calling for mutual aid from other counties with the Cement Mountain Road Fire, 23,000 acres, I believe. There was no other stations. Every other station in every county surrounding us already had their own fires and everybody was out. On the second day when we started receiving help from TIFMIS, we received 5 or 6 trucks from Dallas. We put them in working structure protection behind structures off one of our main highways. There was still live fire that we couldn't get to with our trucks. They worked at it all day, keeping the fire off structures until we could get further help and get dozer resources and get in there and work the fire.
There are times as firefighters that we can be aggressive in containing and controlling wildfires. On a day where the Southern Plains outbreak weather events are occurring, these are not days to be aggressive. We need to evacuate folks that are out in front of these fires, and the areas of the fire that we have to work are at the rear and the flanks.
Well, I guess in emergency management, the first 24 hours is probably the most hectic and maybe the least organized, because I've got a finite number of people here in the county that are first responders. You know, my 8 fire departments have probably got anywhere from 15 to 30, and you know, only a few of those can respond because they're volunteers. Well, this event just went on and on and on. I was very concerned about running out of personnel. We had enough equipment, we had enough water, but I was really concerned about my personnel being just exhausted and unable to keep going. It was very hard to get mutual aid from anybody to the north, like Stevens County, Young County, Palapena County, because they were dealing with their own fires as well. We finally did get some mutual aid from Taylor County and Brown County. Comanche County might have come up as well, but we had to draw mutual aid from counties that weren't fighting their own fires at that time. We didn't have any air assets because they couldn't fly because the wind was so bad, and some of them were, of course, were diverted off to other places where they could fly, and that's, of course, that's where they needed to go, to other counties. We tried to get in front of the fire, both figuratively and literally, by sending out law enforcement and some other first responders to evacuate. The part of the county where this fire started is not very heavily populated. However, as the wind pushed it eastward, it went into an area that does have quite a bit of population. And we were very fortunate that we were able to get everybody out of their homes and ultimately didn't lose any homes.
County officials, county government, law enforcement, you know, the focus should be on moving folks out of the way. These fires move so fast. You can basically, if you know where it is at any given point, take a string on a map and move it out 20 miles in the direction of the wind. If the wind's out of the west or northwest, you know, pull that string across the map and you know where it's going to go. And if there's any communities, if there's any subdivisions, homes, those folks need to be warned and should be made to leave before the fire arrives, if possible.
So what can you do to make sure your community is prepared for a firestorm? Texas Forest Service can help.
And most of our fires occur within 2 miles of a community. So there's steps that communities can take by developing a community wildfire protection plan and adopting a FireWise program to prepare the entire community for a fire before it occurs. Okay. The safer the community, the safer the individual. So we can take steps to protect our property using the Ready, Set, Go program brought to us by the International Association of Fire Chiefs. This program is a three-pronged approach that allows us to prepare for a fire and evacuate safely when one does occur. By utilizing valuable tools like community wildfire protection plans, the FireWise Communities USA program, and Ready, Set, Go, public officials and firefighters give residents the best chance of surviving a wildfire.
For more information about Texas firestorms and how to prepare for them using the Ready, Set, Go and FireWise programs, visit texasfirestorm.org.